we emulate this, you know, and you put all of it in the pool, how Nigeria will benefit from this. I'm very happy. I hope he sees the light of the day. I hope the benefits.
That's right.
We get the benefits from it.
And they stay with the objectives. I know you have so much talk about this, but we just need to move on with the show at this time. Let's go back to Abuja. That's where the Super Eagles are getting ready for that crucial one against the Pharaohs of Egypt. Coach Samson Siasia, I'm sure you know him, very adventurous coach, very disciplined. Three players have been shown the way out already. And then he's impressed with the turnout of the home-based Eagles in camp.
Well, at this time, we have to put everything to ensure that we beat the gym tiers. Because we cannot afford not to go to the Nations Cup again. We didn't attend the last Nations Cup. This coming one is a must for Nigeria. And the way he has approached preparation towards the cracker is a must-win game for us in Kaduna. It's good. He is a tactically sound coach. He's technically adept with what that game demands too. Mm-hmm. So I like it. The axe on three players is good. It's trying to instill discipline in the team. You need discipline. You need focus. Because when you go to the pitch of play, it's not only for you to pass the ball and to run around. You need discipline, you need focus. You need mentally stable players. So how do you get into these players? You need set of players that will be able to communicate with each other based on the focus and the discipline they've learned from training. We need this thing. So by the time the foreign-based players join this team, I believe we're able to present a formidable team that will fight the Egyptians. Because I wouldn't lie to you, Austin and Yemi, it would be a cracker in Abuja. Because the Egyptians, the last time we played them, it was 3-1 in South Africa. Though they are coming to Kaduna to at least pick a draw. Because they know that the day they pick a draw in Kaduna, they are going back to Cairo. And I've experienced the Fizzovirus crowd in Cairo. When Shooting Stars went there in 1996, when we went there in 1996 for the Olympics, it was an easy game. And the Nigerian teams go to Cairo, it's always been a difficult thing.
Table tennis is giving us some hope now that, look, this Egyptian.
It's translated to football. Yeah, it's a different ball game when it comes to football.
I think the other 19 players football. Learned from what happened to the three. And that's why CSR is impressed.
That's right.
Because they know what will happen to them.
Okay, let's leave it at that. Odioni Galu is one of the informed strikers of the Super Eagles of Nigeria. He plays for Watford. He's not scoring for his club at the moment, but he's optimistic that against Egypt, the goals will come. Let's listen to him come out and talk some more. Don't go anywhere.
To this game, I think we have what it takes to win the game, but we have to go there and show it in the field of play, work hard together as a team, fight for every ball to the 90 minute, and by God's grace, we're going to win the game. The second half of the season is always difficult than the first half of the season, you know, because every team now don't want to lose point. Everybody's trying to play safe now and all. But I think we will get a 40 point because with 37, just 3 points to get to the 40 point. And I hope by God's grace we'll get that soon because we still have like 9 games to go in the league. We're still working hard. We don't want to get carried away. We don't want to slip off because of what we've gone through, bad result now in these last 2 or 3 games. But we are confident that we're going to get a 40 point as soon as possible.
So that's it, Odioni Galu speaking, reacting to the performance of his club, Watford, in the English Premier League, and of course, staying optimistic that the Super Eagles of Nigeria can do the job against the Pharaohs of Egypt. Let's go now from one active Super Eagles player to another that has retired, Joseph Yobo, led Nigeria. He was captain of the Nigerian team that went to South Africa to win the 2013 African Cup of Nations. He's retired 100 caps for the country. That's massive, huge achievement right there for the former Everton defender. That's Joseph Yobo right there. Mm-hmm. And Yemi, the story is that there will be a testimonial match to honor this guy on the 27th of May.
I think we've learned from things that have happened in the past. I'm so very happy that we allowed this guy to make the 100 caps, to achieve what some other players didn't get to achieve. Some of the mistakes we made with players like Rashidi Ekini, when people are close to achieving something, you allow them. I mentioned Rashidi Ekini now because he would have probably the all-time goals, he would probably be now the all-time highest goal scorer at the Nations Cup, probably if we had thought about history. And now this man, a fitting way for the service that he has given to his fatherland, all the years that he's that he has played. You cannot fault Joseph Yobo for commitment. And I'm very happy. Mm. A lot of players will come here and do that sending off for him.
That's right.
Friends, international players. You could expect to see the top players on the continent, maybe the likes of Didier Drogba and all those players, just to show respect what Joseph Yobo has done for us. Six Nations Cup, three World Cup appearances, yes, and captain of the team that won. I mean, he has done everything a player would dream to do. And it just seems like yesterday in 2001, when he made his debut for the Super Eagles, you know, an aging Super Eagles that they were trying to rebuild at that point.
Nations Cup qualifier, World Cup qualifier?
It was a season where they were playing Nations Cup and World Cup qualifiers simultaneously. Right. And he got to the team, he did well. I'm very happy for him. And that should be a lesson for us, other players. Let's not allow our players to bow out unceremoniously.
That's right.
No matter what they do,
let's
give them a fitting send off.
And to add to what Yemi has just said now, I'm so happy now that we are not celebrating our stars because we have passing message to the young ones that go to the national team.
Right.
That if you play for the national team, one day you'll be celebrated.
You'll not be forgotten.
The labors of our heroes.
Because by the time you see the likes of Leda Motel, Ozamazan, the top people that have long caps for their country, they are well celebrated. Yeah. But in Nigeria, as Yemi really said, we just allow our stats just go like that, unceremoniously. It's not good. You're passing bad message that no matter your effort, no matter what you put into the national team, one day you'll be discarded and be left out just like that. But it's good that you're celebrating Yobo, because I could remember very well in 2002, when Olise had scuffle with the then Minister for Sport, Ishaya Makaku. He was there in that competition.
Yeah.
And he played all through to 2014. 12 years in the national team. He's not a tea party.
I totally agree with you. So that's the story. A testimonial match will be played in honor of Joseph Yobo, former Super Eagles captain, on the 27th of May 2016 at the Adoke Amesimaka Stadium in Port Harcourt River Stadium. He has told us that he's expecting Wayne Rooney, he's expecting Kolo Touré, and also David Moyes. Do you know? Do you know that Joseph Yobo was the first player that David Moyes signed
as Everton coach?
Yes. As Everton coach. Yes. So that's a
story.
And
Wayne Rooney was a 17-year-old
at the time
in that team.
That's right.
At that point.
So it'll be good. We're waiting. May 27. We will talk about that when it's done. Let's talk about the UEFA Champions League now. Games are being played. That's it right there. Nobody's scoring tonight. And as it is, a good one for Real Madrid against AS Roma. And then Wolfsburg also. From the first leg,
I think the job has been done from the first leg. I'll be surprised if Ghent or Roma are able to turn this. Roma need three as it stands. I don't see them getting that. For Ghent, two unreplied goals. I don't know. Against a German side, well-drilled German side. I don't know if it's possible. So my smart money will be on Real Madrid and Wolfsburg. And it's not even very hard. They're not making it hard for me to pick those two. Because it seemed to me that they've done it from the first leg.
That's right. So that's the story. A good one for Real Madrid. Halftime in that game against AS Roma. We also told you that Arsenal are playing an FA Cup replay match against Hull City. Gunners fans will be smiling at this time because it's Arsenal 3, Hull City 0.
Yeah.
UEFA Champions League will continue tomorrow. What a game it will be when Chelsea takes on PSG. Well, I know that one will get you talking. And Chelsea fans are looking forward to that game. They're optimistic that they can turn things around.
That surely will be the earth coming down at the Stamford Bridge. Because PSG, I know they're not like the likes of Zlatan Ibrahimovic. This is the last chance to have a shot at the Champions League. That's only
trophy
that is missing his cabinet.
Mm.
And Chelsea, so with the way they are going, they've gone on beating at the local level under Guzindic. They'll try to, everything in the arsenal to win this match against PSG. Yeah. So I'm seeing a cracker. I'm expecting total football, entertaining football, all-out football, full of running, movement, passes, and it should be a great game tomorrow.
So you're not expecting packing of any bus?
Tomorrow you can't park at the bus because it's
you're
something.
You're not in a situation Chelsea, where you can't park the bus.
Chelsea have lost the first leg, they must come out. That's they must get a goal. PSG knows, so if Chelsea gets a goal, they must get a goal too. So it's a game.
I think Chelsea know the only realistic route back into the Champions League is if they win the Champions League. I don't see them making it back into the top four. On the strength of that, I think Chelsea might make it.
As for PSG, they won the first leg by 2-1. They will be going to Stamford Bridge. They already at Chelsea.
And again, don't take it away. The money that been invested in PSG, mm-hmm. they've been to the World Cup, mm-hmm. and they've been winning the League One. And the Champions League.
No, the League One is not a league anymore.
It's not a league anymore. It's a one-man league.
Oh my goodness.
You need Champions League to repay the investment of the team.
Let's see. What with the UEFA Champions League is a different story. So we're waiting. The UEFA Champions League should also get you talking. Talk to us in the hashtag Champions League. Real Madrid playing AS Roma, Wolfsburg playing Ghent, and we're waiting for Chelsea versus PSG. Let's talk about Maria Sharapova. I told you that story at the start of the program. She's been taking this drug Meldonium for over 10 years. She's been taking it since 2006. She says whenever she feels sick, she takes the drug. In January this year, WADA added that drug into its banned list. A mail was sent to Maria Sharapova. She read the mail but didn't click on the attached file to see that drug shouldn't be taken anymore. She came out to talk about this really emotional.
And I think that's why we're all showing her some love and solidarity. But of course, she's going to have to pay the price, unfortunately. The drug is not banned in Latvia, where it's made. It's not banned in Russia. And she's been using it for 10 years. But guess what, Austin? Mm. The producers of the drug are saying, you said you've used this thing for 10 years. Mm. If you are treating anything, you just need 4 to 6 weeks. And that for me, that is, you know, all through today, I've been sympathetic.
But you now understand? You're seeing the other
but,
side.
You know, she's seen a lot of, you know, solidarity. And you see, and some of our colleagues said, a lot of people give drugs to athletes, not telling them the truth. They will say, no worry, there will be no traces. Mm. It is not banned. And those are the two things a sports person that is feeling sick wants to hear.
That's right.
It's not banned, and there will be no traces. That's just what they want to hear. And once they start using that, and it makes them get... I mean, you would pity her when she said...
I understand.
Family history of diabetes, this kind of sickness, and all that.
Olawale, let's listen to Maria Sharapova again and react to that. She got really emotional. Serena Williams says, look, Maria, what you did was very courageous, and your integrity will stay with tennis. Let's listen to her right back.
Well, I have to take full responsibility of it because it's my body and it's what I put into my body, and I can't blame anyone for it but myself, no matter who I'm working with. I think it's very important to have a great team around you with coaches and doctors, but at the end of the day, everything you do is about you. Well, I'm still working through my injury, and that was the reason I withdrew from Palm Springs, is because I still have not healed my injury. It made me healthy, and that's why I continue to take it.
So that's it, Maria Sharapova. Olawale, I like the fact that she said, look, I take full responsibility for all of this.
I lay emotional, pathetic, but that was a costly oversight on her own part. Hmm. And it's good that she has taken full responsibility. And Serena Williams, as she rightly said, her integrity will stay with her. Hmm. I know she'll be given like 2 years ban. From there, she'll come back into the sports of which she has not been tested before.
That's right.
And we hope to see Sharapova in the nearest future. But to me, it's a lesson to other athletes.
I don't think it's a given that she'll take 2 years, because if the lawyers, and that's where they're going, if they can prove mitigating circumstances, that is what, you know, if it was an honest mistake, I agree, an honest mistake, 2 years.
Yeah.
If it was deliberate, four.
Oh, yes.
If you can prove and that is hard with what the producers of the drug have got. It's going to be very hard. But I know that's the defense the Sharapova team will come up with, mitigating circumstances. That's very difficult.
Wow. And the reason why I said 2 years is that I've seen that in many situations like this, athletes have gotten 2 years, like
first of
that Damola Osayomi, the last one, he got 2 years too. But it's a lesson for other athletes.
Big lesson.
That you don't listen to only advice. You have,
to go,
Olawale. Investigation
I know.
Before you take drugs.
Yeah,
thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Olawale. Inshallah, for coming out.
Thank
my
you,
colleague,
Austin.
Yemi Adebayo. You see, if you leave these sports, guys, we'll just keep going. That's because sports is so much fun. That's the show. But remember, you can keep talking to us on Twitter, our channels _ sports, and on Facebook, our channels I feel sports. Happy International Women's Day. But as you celebrate women, remember, keep talking sports. Bye for now.